Timelapse videos are a neat way to show the making of process of your project. There are several different ways to record these digitally. If you want to see a specific method, please use the timestamps to skip ahead. To record your timelapse, you can use some kind of screen or window capture software. I recommend using OBS. It is free and has many convenient features. But of course, other recording softwares would work too. So at first, I will tell you how to set it up. Before you start recording, go into the settings and click on Video. For the resolution, I chose the one off the screen that I'm recording. Which frame rate you choose is up to you. Timelapse videos don't really need a very high frame rate. It depends on how much you speed up your timelapse later during editing. For example, if you speed up the recording to 10 times faster, then a recording frame rate of 3 FPS will result in 30 FPS. If you are not sure, just go for a higher frame rate. Having too many frames is better than having too few. Then go to Output and Recording. These settings will determine the properties of your recording. MP4 is a good recording format. If you have the option to use a graphics accelerated encoder, like this one by Nvidia, then choose that one. You can choose which output resolution you want to use. And the settings down here will determine the quality and file size of your recordings. I normally use CQP, constant quantization parameter. It is varying the bitrate depending on how much visual change is happening in the recording. The bitrate basically determines the picture quality of your video. The CQ level is for the maximum quality allowed. It ranges between 1 and 30. The lower the number, the higher the maximum and average bitrate. Now this depends on how much visual change is happening on your screen. I have a very high number because I just use it for recording Clip Studio Paint. All the menus barely change visually, mostly just the canvas. Most of the time, I just do some kind of brush strokes. When I move or zoom in and out, then there is more going on, but only for a short amount of time. So 27 for the CQ level is enough for me. How much you need might be different though. Normally you won't need a value lower than 20 though. If you are not sure, just do some quick test recordings with different CQ levels and look closely if you see any quality differences. Alternatively, you could also use VBR, variable bitrate. With this setting, you have more control over how high your bitrate can go. Higher resolutions and frame rates will require more bitrate to ensure a good quality. For time lapses, you won't need a very high bitrate. For 1080p and 30 FPS, 3000 kilobit per second could already be enough. Again, if you are not sure, just go ahead and make some quick test recordings with different settings. You also have the option to set up global hotkeys for starting and stopping the recording under the Hotkeys tab. If you set it up to be the same hotkey like I did, then it will switch back and forth and not do both of these commands at the same time. Alright, enough with the setting stuff. Next up, you'll need to create a new scene, name it however you want, and then add a source. You can either use Display Capture, which, as the name suggests, records anything that is going on the screen that you choose, or Window Capture, which only records a specific window. Choose whichever one you prefer. Window Capture, in my opinion, is more convenient, but might be weirdly cut off with some settings. Changing the capture method can fix that though. Make sure your capture is fully shown on the screen here. You can also hide the cursor if you want to. The display capture has that option. And so does the window capture, but only on the bitblt capture method. And there you go, you can simply click on start recording and begin doing work on your project. It's also possible to pause the recording. However, if you're anxious like I am about the program or your system crashing and losing the entire recording, then just stop and start the recording every time when you take a break. It is safer this way. So this is one of the most straightforward ways to record footage for a timelapse. With this method, you show everything that is going on your project exactly how you saw it. This also means any scrolling, rotating and zooming. That can result in your timelapse looking quite hectic and confusing if sped up really fast. Depending on what software you use, you can record the full canvas without any of that hectic movement. I know that this works in Clip Studio Paint and Photoshop. And I'm sure that other programs could also use this method. While you have your project open in Clip Studio Paint, you go to Window, Canvas, and then click on New Window. In Photoshop, it would be Window, Arrange, and New Window for so-and-so. This will open a duplicate window of your project. Any changes you make in one of these windows will be applied to the other one, since they share the same file. This side-by-side view makes the canvases a bit too small for working on them and recording though. However, you can drag the duplicate out so that it has its own window. The only thing is that in this state it always stays above the main window. So, if you want to record it while working on the other canvas, there are two things you can do. If you have two monitors, move the duplicate to another monitor and record it from there. The downside is that it shoves itself above other programs too, as long as those programs don't have a stay on top option. If you don't want that, or you only have one screen available, another thing you can do is to drag one of these canvases out and place it right above the other one. Then you window capture the main window of the software, so what is below the extracted canvas. The downside of this method is that the recording of the canvas part will be smaller in total, and switching between projects is more of a hassle. By the way, if you change the canvas size midway through, make sure to check the zoom level of the duplicate canvas. It might get cut off or appear too small. You can take care of that by using Fit to Screen in View or on the Navigator. The last method I want to show you is offered by the graphics program itself. Recently, Clip Studio Paint got a new timelapse function. Procreate has something similar, and maybe some other programs too that I don't know of. In Clip Studio Paint, you go to File, Timelapse, and there you have Record Timelapse and Export Timelapse. Alternatively, you can put these on your command bar and quick access menu. When you click Record, it saves all the changes to the file in the file itself. Warning, the save file can get quite large this way. Click on Export Timelapse and this window will show up. It gives you a little preview of the timelapse. The highest export resolution is 1280 pixels for the longer side of the canvas. If the horizontal length is larger, then the max resolution for the horizontal side is 1280 pixels and the vertical side adjusts to it and is smaller. If the vertical length is larger, then the same would be the case but with the sides switched. It is not a real-time recording, unlike the previous methods I showed. Instead, every single frame is one change, one brush stroke, transformation, color adjustment, or whatever else. A slow brush stroke that took 3 seconds to draw therefore becomes equally long as a quick line drawn in a fraction of a second. The frame rate of the exported video is always 30 FPS, you cannot change it. This method does not deal well with changes to the aspect ratio. It basically just crams everything into the aspect ratio you chose, so parts of the video can end up really small. If you want to pause the recording, then that's not a simple thing to do. It has no pause function. When you stop the recording, it deletes all the timelapse data recorded so far. So you would have to export everything at first, stop the recording, and then start it again when you want to resume it. All in all, it is a convenient feature, but definitely has some limitations and downsides. So there we go, those are a couple of examples that I can give you. They all have their up and downsides. Which one you want to use depends on what you need. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any questions or constructive feedback, then please let me know in the comments. Have fun recording!